know, that was a good night in the office. You must be delighted. You know, made 10 changes. A lot of young lads, and they've really stepped up to the plate. What's your overall thoughts?
Yes, absolutely. So I'm pleased. Away win at the Premier League side is always a really good result, and there must be a good performance. But I think the performance today was really outstanding, because from the first second, I got the feeling we had everything under control. We're dominating the game with our possession, and yeah, thank God we were also able today to use our chances to be really clinical in the finishing situations, to go in lead and to score a second goal. And it's always complicated against Cardiff, because they are always there with physical threats, and it's always difficult to defend all the set pieces. And for that, it was important to stay in possession today and to keep the ball and to dominate the ball with our possession with the ball, to keep them away from our goal. And yeah, then it's also important in football to take your well-deserved credit. And today we were able to be also brutal in our finishing. And in general, I'm well-deserved win. I'm totally pleased.
Probably a little bit unfair to pick out individuals, but inevitably Dennis getting a brace. Tell me your thoughts on the goals themselves and what that'll do for his confidence as well.
Yeah, for a striker it's always important that he scores. Good for self-confidence. But with Dennis, I'm pleased with his workload from the first day I was working with him. So he was there with a brilliant pre-season, and I think he scored the most goals in the whole pre-season. And yeah, in the first league games he was not so much involved, because we have also a lot of competition in this position, because Jordan Rhodes was there, was scoring, Timo Pukki was there, was scoring. Right now also Dennis Sabini is scoring, so all my offensive players are scoring at the moment, even on Hernandez. And hopefully they can go on. It's a situation you like as a coach, and pleased for Dennis, and also important for his self-confidence. Yes.
Max Aarons gets the other one. He's obviously not inside for his goal-scoring ability, but what can you say about his performance?
Don't place the young lads too much. He was there with a solid performance. It was good, yes.
I think you've got to give us more than that tonight with Max.
Yeah, I made it clear. So I don't like to speak too much about young lads who have to develop, because I want them to keep their feet on the ground and to keep on further in the hard working, because quality is defined by performance over long term, and not just be there with two good games or four good weeks or perhaps three good months or whatever. It's more like you have to perform on long term, and I want especially my young players to develop in this direction and to be modest and to go further on, and that he's pretty much involved in my plans. Assigned and approved for this, that he was today there was playing 90 minutes, because for me it was not just a cup game. For me the cup has the same importance like the league, and we wanted to go further on. For us it was quite normal that we had several changes today, because it was for us the third game within 6 days, and I think it was necessary to have some recreated players on the pitch. And yeah, Max was one of them, and he was also there with a good performance like the whole team.
Henry Buendia, how close is he to starting a league game for you now? We saw the quality on the back heel for the first goal.
Yeah, pretty close, because when he's allowed to start in the cup game, then he's also ready for starting in the league game. He's probably not there after missing preseason and after being back in training for or since 3 weeks right now to play all 3 days 90 minutes. But he's ready to play at 90 minutes, and was there, I think, also there was a good performance today. And I think after the national break, international break, he will be there with 100%. But he showed today why we were so keen to sign him, and I'm happy to have him.
Well, did you see him? Because, I mean, he was operating slightly wider on the right, but then for the goal itself, he was playing down the middle. I mean, where is his best position?
In Spain, he played a lot on the wing, but he has also the ability to play as number 10 or even as a striker. So perhaps not the big, tall striker who's there with scoring many, many goals per headers, but with smart movements. And it's just important for Emi to find a position where he can influence the game, where he has many touches, where he can play the final pass, when he can assist. And it's also one of his strengths that he's flexible. He can play on the left wing, on the right wing, number 10. And it's also good that the opponent never knows in which position he will come. And I think he will be pretty, pretty important for our future.
We obviously know what's next, Derby trip to Ipswich. How much of a boost will that give you and the players? Because obviously there's a lot of disappointment after Leeds, but you're going to bounce into that game Sunday now, aren't you?
Yeah, so a win is always good for the self-confidence and also for the mood, and especially when you are there with such a good performance and an away game at a Premier League side in such an important game, then It's always good for the self-confidence and for the mood. And in general, I can judge the beginning of the season. I think we were in general there with really, really good performances in the cup competition with perfect results and in the league anyhow. Yeah, it's a bit ridiculous. I think our poorest game we won against Preston at home, and all the other games we were sometimes there with really good performances. But anyhow, we left several points because of individual mistakes. And normally we should stand here with 4 or 5 points, at least more. But it's like it is, you have to face the reality, and for that I think it's important that we keep on performing on this level like we did in nearly all of our games so far, but also to reward ourselves with more points. That's quite important as well, and that's what you're trying to do, to keep on performing on this level, and also to take ourselves, to reward ourselves with a well-deserved credit, and that's what we also want to do in Ipswich.
Some of those younger players giving you a nice selection headache for something.
Yeah, it's always good when there are many good performances, and it's also good to have competition in the squad. And I totally trust my lads and the depth in our squad. And in general, I can judge whoever played so far in this season. We were normally always there with really good performances. Okay, take perhaps a bit the individual mistakes away that cost us some points, but in general, so in which formation we played. In which beige formation or who was involved in the starting lineup, we were always there with good for performances. So take our strikers, whoever played, he's scoring, and that's a good situation, and hopefully we can go on, perform on this level, and to win many, many points.
It's final one for me. Friday, transfer deadline in terms of loans. You said yesterday it's going to be fairly quiet. Is that still the case, you think?
I think it will be quiet, so you can't predict anything in this business, so sometimes there's something crazy, and there can something happen pretty late. We won't fall asleep, we will always be awake for some options and weigh up our options, but in general I don't expect anything, because I'm totally pleased with our group of players, and I want all to stick together with us, and I'm also also totally pleased with our size. I won't say that there is no business, but I expect pretty quiet days.